Okay, the two things you need to download here as part of object identification. Now to identify the objects in the page, maybe it may be link or web edit. So we right now we have to start right performing operations on the web page. So before performing operations, you need to identify that particular object. So to perform that operation, there is one technique via Firefox, that is you can download Firebug and Firebot. These two are add-ons to the Firefox which will help us to give the properties of the objects present in the web page. Okay, so to download Firebug, just Google the download, Google the with the search keyword, then you will get the first link. Okay, open it and download that. So once you download and restart your machine, you will get a symbol here says that Firebug, click on it. But when you download for first time, you will not get this Firepath link tab, you won't get, because that is an additional add-on which you need to download it separately so that it will be added as extension to the Firebug. You just try, once you download and see, you will not find this Firepath. Okay, you download the Firepath again as I said you here and add download now and restart your machine. Then when you click on that Firebug, when you open your Firebug, then you will identify that you have seen Firepath tab here with this text box. Okay, so I'll tell you now why I'm using these two extensions to identify the objects. Okay, let's see. I'll go to facebook.com. One second. Give me a moment, I am just making changes here. Yeah. Well, first, do we have to download Firefox to download Firefox? Yes, you need to have Firefox browser. I'm showing the easiest way, because you need not worry every time about Firefox. Okay, you can do it in Chrome and IE also, but I'm starting with the easiest way so that you can get the things soon. So open the Firebug and click on it. Click an element in the page to inspect. First, you click on this particular link and again click on the object where you are interested in this web page. Then I am interested in this text box, okay? And I'll just click on it and then you see some kind of code is generated regarding that particular email text box. Fine. So now with this stuff, we will try to identify the property of email and use that in our Selenium to automate. So let's see what are those.